College Prep Academy is one of the charter schools doing well in Port St. Lucie. So to talk to us about why that happens and some of the good things going on there today, we brought in a group of people. We have Principal Erica Raines joining us and also two students, Brianna and
Carrie Ann.
Thank you, Brianna and Carrie Ann, both for joining us. We'll start with Ms. Raines. You're the principal out there at Somerset College Prep Academy. Changed names not so long ago. What was the name of the school before?
It was the College Preparatory Academy of the Treasure Coast. So we dropped of the Treasure Coast and added Somerset.
Okay, great. And let's talk, before we get into details about the school, let's talk about the idea of a charter school in the first place. What exactly is a charter school?
A charter school is a public school. It's just non-traditional. Charter schools are publicly funded. There is no tuition paid, and they are sponsored by the district, meaning that the district make sure that we're meeting all state and federal requirements. And the benefit to a charter school is that we have curricular autonomy and flexibility in the classroom. We're able to meet the students' needs where they need to be met. We're not held to the same scope and sequence or pacing guides that the district uses. We do have to meet the state standards, the common standards. We do have to do state standardized testing, but we don't necessarily do all of the benchmark testing that the district does every couple of weeks. So we have a little bit more curricular flexibility and autonomy.
So there is oversight from the school district and your answer to the state standards, but you're allowed a little more freedom in how you get to those things?
That's correct.
And I think because teachers in the classroom, they kind of are the ones, the boots on the ground, so to speak, that they know best what's working for this particular group of kids and what's not, and it allows them the freedom to make those decisions?
That's our philosophy. They spend 8 hours a day with the kids. They know them best. They know their needs, their weaknesses, and their strengths, and they know what they need to do to meet those.
And how are the results? I know you brought us a couple of really good students today. Are you finding it successful? Is the idea working? Do you see students moving along as they should?
We are an A school.
Excellent.
Results speak for themselves.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That doesn't come very easily. You've really got to earn that.
No, actually our first year we were a C school. Keeping in mind that the components that are factored to give a school a grade for the high school, we don't have all of the components because we don't yet have a graduating class. We opened with 9th grade, added 10th. We're 9th, 10th, and 11th now. So we don't have that graduation class to draw from yet, the graduation rate, but we have all the rest of the criteria. Our first year, we didn't have writing scores. They gave us the district's writing scores. We had a C. Our second year open, we made an A.
Okay. So now Somerset has a new location as well. Let's talk about that.
We are still leasing a building on the IRSC campus in St. Lucie West. We're still in the same building we started out in, but we have 300 students in that building, which is about max capacity. So we have, we've been exploring opening a brand new facility on the northeast corner of California and Peacock. So it's just on the other side of IRSC. We've made it through site plan review committee. We've made it through planning and zoning. Next step is city council.
And how many students will be in that place?
At total build-out, and build-out will occur over about five phases, possibly four, but about five phases. At total build-out, it's a 1,500-student station.
Is there a long-term plan to move the school somewhere else and build a whole different campus?
That's what that is. That is the long-term plan.
That
we are the current facility, the current lease, is a year-to-year lease. We're good till 2019, but we can cancel at any point. And then the new facility, once we get through city council, through our two readings, assuming that they approve it and everything goes as planned, pull in the permits and all of that, the goal is maybe a winter break move-in for next year, 2015 winter break, maybe December or 2016 January move in.
Okay. You've brought today a couple of students who are part of the school there, just as an example of some of the kind of ways that they grow and develop and learn, and a good example of some students. So we've got two of you. We've got Brianna. So you are the president of student government?
Yes, I am.
Okay. What grade are you in?
I am in 11th grade. I'm a junior.
And you've been doing student government since 9th grade?
Since 9th grade, yes.
And what motivated you to get involved in student government?
I really wanted to get involved with student government because I saw how much work Ms. Raines had put into getting the school here, and I wanted to almost give back to her in a way that the students would be able to, you know, let their voices be heard, because in traditional public high schools, I feel like the administration like almost overpowers the students, and the students are the ones that really, you know, make the school what it is. And as student government, I just wanted to be able to let those students have their voices be heard. And with, you know, having such a small school, Mr. Ains really is great with, you know, working with student government and working with all the students, and it's just a great organization.
Yeah, and you try to get other kids involved in that as well,
yeah.
Encourage them to be involved in it.
Yes, sir.
All right. And then we have Carrie Ann. You are, I guess there you have a title, is it Miss Sparta? Did
yes.
I get that right? Okay, and what is that all about?
Miss Sparta is basically a competition or pageant compiled together, and it's not based on beauty. It's based on we have to go through different steps in order to be into the pageant. It's 12 girls who come together based on you have to write an essay, you have to go through an interview in front of a panel of four judges, you have to have a minimum amount of community service hours, and then you have to also really understand different questions that you can be asked on top on stage. And throughout the Miss Sparta process, you go out into businesses, you see if you can get sponsored by different companies, so you're really getting involved in the community. And also one of the aspects of Miss Sparta is to go out and find an organization in which you can volunteer at, be a part of the community, and really show the other students at the school or parents or family who end up coming to the pageant, this is an organization that I support, here's how you can help it, here's how you can really get involved in it as well.
So how did you feel when you were in front of that interview panel to sit there and have to give answers?
At first, it was definitely a little bit nerve-wracking, but the more that I practiced in front of, you know, the other girls in the pageant, I was able to go in front of the panel with confidence and just kind of be myself. And that's, I think, what Miss Sparta is really about, just learning who you are and connecting with all the other people in the pageant.
And that's kind of, Miss Rains, that idea, what you just said, real important, just kind of learning who you are and both of them having to deal with other people. Is that really what's the thinking behind this kind of stuff?
Absolutely. Absolutely. One of the things that Bree had mentioned is students having more of a voice in the school. And for our school, our students do a lot of the problem solving. They do anything that they want done, any type of an extracurricular activity or sport that they want, they have to take the lead on it. They have to figure it out. I'm busy running the academics of the school. Anything extra, they have to take the lead on. They come back with presentations. They have to sell it. They have to get approval. They have to figure out how to finance it. And they do a very good job. One of the other things that Bree did, Bree actually, with one of the other students, she started our cheerleading squad. It was our second year. They wanted it the first year, but it took a year for them to put it together, to figure out how to make it happen. And they learn a lot about themselves and what they're capable of. In the traditional public schools, we do it all for them. Everything's already set and done, and they just have to step in and participate. These kids have to get out there and build it. They have to figure out how to make it happen if they want it. The critical thinking skills, the analytical skills, and the problem-solving skills that they discover as they're going through this process is just amazing, and the growth is phenomenal with these kids.
And that's the real learning, all of those things for each of you.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever your interests are, you'll have to take those same kinds of skills into anything in the future.
Definitely.
Just going out and talking to others, and you got to worry about, what are they going to think of me if I do this? What if I say that? But you kind of then get people, as student government, you got to kind of get people around an idea, get them motivated, and find out where that idea takes it.
Yeah.
It's politics. You're involved in politics, really.
Yeah.
Politics isn't always a bad thing. Sometimes we hear, oh, it's all politics.
Mm-hmm.
City Hall is all about politics. But there's not a better way. This is where people get together. They get voted by the public.
Mm-hmm.
They go out and try to convince people to vote for them because they think their idea will work.
Mm-hmm.
They want to do something good, get something accomplished. And then they meet together every Monday night in City Hall here, and they talk about how to make the city a better place.
Yeah.
There's not a better way, because otherwise it's going to be done by force, and that's not good. So you're really learning those very same skills right now, whether it's in student government or out there with the Miss Sparta program, going out to businesses, meeting people.
Mm-hmm.
Now you got to convince them about what your idea is and see if you can get them on board. Excellent skills for students. Would you recommend, Brianna, would you recommend charter schools for other kids in the future?
I would definitely recommend. I've been in charter schools my whole life, so I wouldn't be able to say, you know, what the difference is between a public school and a charter school. But from what I know about, you know, traditionals and what my, you know, friends say that go to other public schools, charter schools are definitely the way to go. They're more focused on academics. They're more focused on preparing you for the future, not just getting you through school and just that's it. they really focus on, you know, careers and college and going farther, because in, you know, most high schools they're like, okay, you know, you finish high school, that's it, we don't care. But that's definitely not what it's like here. It's, we're preparing you for the future. We're, you know, charter schools are definitely
they want to see you go on.
Do they want to see you go on? Yes.
And Carrie Ann, would you recommend charter schools for other kids in the future?
Yes, most definitely. I feel, especially with our school in particular, we really have so many opportunities, and it's not just like, okay, here's your path that you're going to take, just follow the steps to get through high school. It's more you're really involved in how you're going to set out your future for yourself. The faculty and the teachers and Ms. Rains, they provide, you know, the support and the steps for it, but you're the one who really takes in the opportunity for yourself to make it what you want it to be.
Key point there. As great as charter schools can be, and you got good people backing you with Ms. Rains and the crew, that self-initiative part, that thing that comes from within you, is really so key. Without that, all the assistance and good programs in the world don't really work, do they, Ms. Rains?
Absolutely.
Not quite the same. And you can, and it's your job to stir up that motivation in them internally and make it happen. If somebody wants to know more about Somerset Academy, you got a website?
Absolutely, www.cpatc.org.
Very good. It's getting into charter school, the process for that.
It is an application process. We actually don't have any more seats right now for this school year. The students have to apply. Typically, the application period is November 1st through February 1st. It's a random application process. They do, for the high school, they do have to have a 2.0 minimum GPA. They have to reside in the county. And when they fill out that online application that is on our website, they submit proof of residency as well as their most recent report card to show that they do meet that GPA minimum. If we have more applications than seats available, we hold a random lottery. If we have fewer applications than seats, then all students who qualify are admitted.
Excellent. Well, I appreciate everybody taking the time to join us today, Brianna and Carrie Ann. Good luck on your future endeavors, and we appreciate that you're working hard and trying to do the right thing to get a good education and move on in life, and that's always good to hear and refreshing to hear young people out there moving ahead and doing the right thing and making the right choices. That's just so rewarding to all the rest of the adult world. Erica Rains, principal at Somerset, we appreciate your time. Doing
Thank
a good job
having.
As evidenced by this. Congratulations on the
you.
A rating.
Thank you.
And we're hoping for good things from Somerset in the future.
Thank you very much.
All right, good to have you.
Thank you.
And we'll be back after this quick message, so stay with us.